Oh, it's crazy, bro. I think it's crazy, like, how people be saying that you tell them about Jesus is you forcing, you know, your religion on them and that you're indoctrinating them. And I don't really think that's true. And I'm going to tell you why. I'm going to tell you why. Like, why I don't believe, I don't think, and I know it's not true. Because I think that truly, if people fully stood by that proclamation, that claim, that position, for them to point that out, they'll also have to point out all the other things that is being influenced within this culture. So there's many other things that are being pushed within this culture. There's many other agendas being pushed within this culture. And you don't have a decision what's going to pop up on your TikTok when you get on it. You didn't know you were going to pull up on this video talking about impact and influence. You did not know I was going to pull up on your TikTok video, but here we are. I'm talking to you. I'm in your screen. You know, now I can speak to you. Like, you know what I'm saying? But you don't have a choice. What you have to see. You are a victim. You are a victim to influence, whether you like it or not. And so, if you are a victim to influence, when you want the right influence, oh God, I didn't know I was going to get this deep today. If you are a victim to influence, because even if you say, oh, I ain't a victim of influence, I'm my own person. Boy, you look like everybody around you. Stop playing. Everybody around you, everybody that's around you, you look just like them. So anyways, carrying on. Anyway, so listen, when you want the right influence around you, when you want the Lord Jesus, and of course people be like, no, bro, you know, I understand, but that's too much, bro. Like, I'm just trying to live my life. No, this is life, bro. Living for Christ is life. It's not restriction. It's not religion. It's not laws and regulations. It's freedom. Jesus said, hallelujah, the thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy. And he was referring to the devil. The thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But I have come that you may have life and life more abundantly. Now, this is Jesus talking. He said, I've come that you may have life in it more abundantly. That's Jesus. That's not a prosperity preacher. That's not somebody, oh, I see a blessing coming of it. No, that's Jesus talking. He wants you to live life and life more abundantly in him. You can't live life and life more abundantly outside of Christ. John 15, it talks about, you know, we're able to bear much fruit when we abide in him. You cannot bear fruit outside of Christ. Because then essentially, if you look at a plant, if you look at a tree, you know, it doesn't matter how much I want, you know, this fruit to grow. If I detach the branch from that tree, it's not going to grow. It's going to wither up and die. And that is what our lives, that's the result of our lives. When we remain detached from God, we're going to wither up. Our life is going to wither up some way, somehow, and it's just going to be lifeless. You could say right now, oh, bro, what you talking about, bro? I'm living my life up. But let's just be real, bro. You don't like your life. You don't like your life. You have everything that you might have everything that you want. You might not have everything that you want. You know what I'm saying? But nevertheless, this is be real. You don't like your life, bro. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Because you could be, oh, bro, I got all this, I got all that, but you're still depressed. You still don't know your purpose. You still don't know why you're on this earth. So yeah, you have all this and that, but you still don't know who you are. You still don't know your self-worth. Yeah, I know my self-worth. Can we just be real? Can we just be real? Like, you know what I'm saying? And I feel like that's the first thing in coming to Christ. Just be real with yourself. Be real with yourself, man. You know what I'm saying? And so back to, again, with the indoctrination. I don't believe it's indoctrination. The reason I don't believe it's indoctrination, again, is because every time you come on this app, you're being indoctrinated. You come on this app, you see someone's rare behind. You come on this app, you see someone bumping vulgar music and doing, you know, all these dance moves. You know, you know what I'm saying? Every time you come on here, you're being indoctrinated. So me telling you about Jesus, he's ultimately the best thing in your life. Amen. Like, you know what I'm saying? So you should actually be thanking the people that are preaching to you and talking to you because they love you. Those are people that actually love you. That's because I do love y'all, man, for real. If I didn't love you, I wouldn't be telling you this. I'll just tell you, this, if I didn't love you, this is what I would say. You know, guys, you know, just live your life to the fullest, man. Just, you know, YOLO, bro. You know, just go out there. Just go get, man. Like, that's what I would tell you if I didn't love you. Because that's the worst advice. That's the worst advice you could ever get somebody. Especially as young. Just go out there and just live it, bro. Worst advice. Go out there and live it? No. No. You need wisdom. You said you should... That the first thing is wisdom, counsel. People, they need structure. They need order within their lives. Because those are a lot of things that young people don't have. And I'm saying this because I know. These are things I'm looking for and I'm seeking for in my life. Is order, structure, vision, wisdom, you know, understanding. People, you know what I'm saying? People that have fallen in life that are older, they understand these things. They're like, yeah, bro. You know what I'm saying? They be trying to put the youth on, but we don't be listening. You know, I just want to do my own thing, man, you know? Because all my friends and I, yeah, bro. You, if you follow your friends, bro, and your friends, they follow the Lord, your friends going to leave you, they're going to lead you to hell, bro. Stop playing. I don't care. Like, seriously. Like, stop playing with your soul, bro. All in the name of friendship, they're going to lead you straight to hell. If they truly your friends, they're going to tell you about Jesus. They're going to try to put you on to the Lord Jesus. You know what I'm saying? So, I just got all serious now. You know, nah, for real. Like, Jesus is always good. What am I saying? No, Jesus is always good. So, you can't tell me that's indoctrination. I'll tell you what is indoctrination. Having these, you know what I'm saying, these young boys out here want to be gangsters. That's what indoctrination is. Because, no, they didn't come out the womb wanting to be like that. There's an influence that came up on them. There's something they saw that came up on them that made them want to be like that. These young girls want to be, you know, out here wearing provocative clothing and want to be like Cardi and Hot Girl Summer. All that. You know, they didn't come out the womb like that. Somebody influenced them. Somebody, they saw something that impacted them and they said, I want to be like that. I think that's indoctrination. Right? I think that's indoctrination. I feel like that is forcing something up on someone. But it's not towards their good. It's for their destruction. So that's why I don't want to hear it, bro. Oh, bro, this generation, man, is going downhill. But we don't need Jesus, though. We don't need God. That don't make no sense to me. That don't make no sense to me. It's because of the indoctrinations and influences that have been imparted into this generation that is the reason the way it is. It's because there's a lack of God that there is an increase of sin. But, you know what I'm saying? That's just the facts. You know, that's just facts. But anyways, y'all, like I'm saying, Jesus ain't trying to force himself upon no one. He's just the truth. He's just the life. And he is just the way of life. And if you can't see that, as God, he can reveal himself to you right now. As Jesus, Lord, I don't even know if you're real for real. Like, Lord, reveal yourself to me, Lord, in Jesus' name. I have all this doubt. I have this unbelief in my heart. I think you're this. I think you're that. People are telling me you're this. People are telling me that. Ask the Lord yourself. He will show you. You'll be surprised. You will be surprised. You know what I'm saying? So... But yeah, bro, we ain't out here trying to force Jesus on you. We just really love you. And guess what? You know why? Because God loves you. And he loved you before the foundations of the world. So stop listening to all these people out here lying to you, man. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.